Good day. Today I'm going to show you how easy and simple it is to put a LIDAR rangefinder on your FPV drone to enable the low altitude terrain following or surface tracking and obstacle avoidance features using ArduPilot firmware. All for only around 25 bucks. I'll show you and go over the specs of the LIDAR rangefinder I've used, show you the simple FPV drone LIDAR setup, then do a quick demo of the drone LIDAR capabilities. The LIDAR rangefinder we'll be using for our FPV drone LIDAR rangefinder setup is this TF Luna LIDAR from Benewake. The first thing I want to point out is how small this thing is. It measures in at about 26 millimeters by 21 millimeters by 13 millimeters and only weighs about 4.5 grams. It's got an operating range of anywhere from about 20 centimeters to 8 meters with an accuracy of 6 centimeters at 3 meters or below and 16 centimeters or about 6 inches at 8 meters. And it operates in the infrared wavelength. You can connect it to your flight controller just by using a spare UART or through I2C connections. Now, for some reason, if you wanted to take it out of its case, it appears all you need to do is remove these 3 screws. Let's go ahead and do that. Here's how small it is outside of its case. Just over 1.5 grams. Of course, you don't have the lenses that are in the plastic case then, which could be an issue. I'm gonna go ahead and put this back together. This diagram shows how I've got the TF Luna LIDAR rangefinder connected to my Matek H743 mini flight controller using a UART connection. 5 volts to 5 volts, ground to ground, RX pad of the LIDAR to the TX pad of the flight controller, and the TX pad of the LIDAR to the RX pad of the flight controller. Once you've got it connected to your flight controller, there's really only 7 parameters you need to set within your ArduPilot firmware, which I'll go over now. Connect to Mission Planner. Go to your Configuration tab, Full Parameter List, search bar over here on the right, just as we've done several times before in our ArduPilot and Arducopter video series playlist, linked below. Here we want to search for and adjust these settings found on the ArduPilot.org doc site for our Benewake TF Luna LIDAR rangefinder and how we've connected it to our flight controller. We've connected ours to UART 7 as shown previously in our wiring diagram. UART 7 on the Matek H743 mini flight controller is serial 1. So the parameters we want to use for our specific setup are serial 1 underline baud equals 115 for 115-200, and you just change these values by typing them in, then write your parameters just as we've done several times before. We want rangefind 1 type equals 20, RNGFND 1 type equals 20 for Benewake serial. We also set rangefind 1 min centimeters equals 20 for our TF Luna minimum operating range distance, and rangefind 1 max to 800 centimeters for our TF Luna LIDAR rangefinder's maximum operating distance. Remember, whenever you change these values, to write the parameters. Once we have our LIDAR rangefinder mounted to our FPV drone, we can measure its physical distance to the ground when pointing in the downward direction. In our case, we get about 2.7 centimeters, or rounding up, it's 3 centimeters. With that measurement, we set RNGFND1 underline GND clear equal to 3. That's our distance in centimeters from the rangefinder to the ground when it's sitting on the ground. This will vary depending upon how you've mounted it to your FPV drone. The last parameter we want to change is our LIDAR rangefinder's orientation on the quadcopter. In our case, it's pointing downward for surface tracking. So we search for and change the parameter RNG FND orient equals 25 for down. Of course, if you're using these LIDAR rangefinders as proximity sensors for object avoidance, you'll want to change this parameter to the value corresponding to the sensor's orientation, such as 0 for facing forward, 2 for facing right, 4 for facing to the rear or back, and so on. That's it. Our FPV drone LIDAR setup is complete. That's all we needed. Now, if you wanted to, it's not necessary, but for our demonstration of its capabilities, we'll set up our rangefinder's measured distance so it's displayed on our OSD. We do that by enabling it using the parameter OSD1 underline RNGF underline EN equal to 1 for enabled. And that's going to display your rangefinder's measured distance in your OSD. You can also place it anywhere you want on your OSD screen using the X and Y horizontal and vertical positions, with 0 being all the way to the left on the screen and 29 being all the way to the right, 0 being all the way at the top of the screen and 15 being all the way at the bottom. And you can set your values to anywhere in between and including these extremes. Remember to write your parameters. Now let's test out our FPV drone LiDAR to make sure it's working. You can do that by connecting your quad to Mission Planner, and with your LiDAR powered on with your LiPo battery and your props off, go to your data window, status tab, and scroll down to the sonar range reading. Here. Now while watching that reading, simply move your quadcopter vertically up and down from the ground and see what the sonar range is reading. You should see these numbers change corresponding to the distance measurements of your LiDAR rangefinder. If you do, it's working. If you don't, go back and check all your connections and set up parameters. Another way to see if your LiDAR is working is to check out the measured distance we just set up in your OSD. Once again, with it powered on, simply move the quadcopter vertically up and down from the ground. Here you see the LiDAR rangefinder's measured altitude near the middle of the screen and the estimated altitude from the extended Kalman filter or EKF subsystem in the lower left of the screen. The estimated altitude from your EKF subsystem is based on your GPS and your barometer. The LiDAR rangefinder provides the system with its altitude measurements when your drone is within the rangefinder's operating range. This modifies the target altitude and enables the altitude control system to adjust its altitude control output. A more detailed explanation of how this works is found on the ArduPilot.org site, Understanding Altitude in ArduPilot. Notice here your LiDAR rangefinder's measured altitude is of higher fidelity or more accurate, shown here to the second decimal point, than your estimated altitude from the EKF subsystem. All right, let's test out our FPV drone LiDAR setup. Here's how we're gonna do this. To simulate hilly terrain, I've got my vehicle parked in the driveway and I'm gonna fly over it without moving my throttle stick. I'll take off in acro mode and hover at an altitude just above the hood of the vehicle. I'll switch to altitude hold mode. Take my hand off the throttle stick and slowly push the pitch stick forward to start flying toward the vehicle. If it all works out as it should, then our FPV drone should automatically fly over the vehicle initiated by the LiDAR rangefinder. Here we go. That's going to do it for today. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Thanks for your time, and I'll catch you next video. Clear skies, friends.